Hi, this is the Political Checklist. I'm Christina Bellantoni, political editor with the PBS NewsHour, joined by senior correspondent Judy Woodruff. And Texas size primary is what finally puts Mitt Romney over the limit to become the official Republican Party nominee. I guess it's not really official until we get to Tampa. But
surprise, Mitt Romney's the Republican nominee.
Exactly. And he really didn't do a lot of fanfare. He put out a paper statement last night. What do you see the Romney campaign moving to next? What's sort of the next step for them as they look at 5 months from now at the election?
I think what they want to do is hammer away at the economy, and they want to get the focus, frankly, back on the president. For the last few weeks, a lot of the focus has been on Bain and Company, which is Bain Capital, where Mitt Romney worked for 15 years, and his record in the private sector, and a number of other sort of side issues. And the Romney campaign is anxious to get the focus back on the president, back on the economy. Wherever Mitt Romney goes, he's talking about that, but that hasn't been being picked up in the news, and that's what they want. They feel that's how they're going to win or lose this election. They know this is not an easy path for them to win in November. They don't have as many ways to get this done, if you talk about the electoral college, but right now for them, it's let's hammer away at the president, at his what they call his failed record, and that's what I think you're going to hear Mitt Romney talk about over and over and over again.
And the super PACs that support Mitt Romney are sort of echoing that message. And we walked through those electoral college scenarios you mentioned in our Vote 2012 Map Center on Monday night on the show, looking at 7 to 8 swing states that you're really going to see a lot of activity. You've got Nevada, Iowa, Florida, New Hampshire, Colorado, Wisconsin, and I'm sure I'm forgetting one. Oh, of course, Ohio. So, really we're going to see a lot of action in that. One thing you're also seeing a lot of action on is sort of this online campaign. And so Mitt Romney today released a new iPhone app that we've got here on an iPad. And as you can see, they did spell America wrong. I'm sure they're going to be fixing that too soon. But there are all kinds of ways that you can say, I'm with Mitt. This is a way you can take a picture, and then send the campaign your photograph and say, I'm with Mitt. This is, a strategy that the president used a lot in 2008, but Romney's sort of starting to catch up on that. How do you see him faring with technology this year?
Well, I think the Obama campaign has a head start because they went through this in 2008, and online was very much a part of the Obama strategy in 2008, and they had that to build on. And they like to say that they've been doing that from day one, that they've been thinking about online as they've been thinking about on-the-ground organizing from the first day after President Obama was elected president, became president. Having said that, the Romney camp has a lot of money, and we can talk about that as you like, but that money will go, some of it, to trying to play catch up with the Obama camp.
We'll be talking about that on the NewsHour tonight, looking at where these campaigns are actually investing their resources. The Obama campaign has spent enormous amounts of money building these sorts of tools way early on, and the Romney camp is doing that catch up.
And one thing that's different, and you and I have talked about this, Christina, is that there truly is micro-targeting of voters this year. And what does that mean? That means with this amazing technological ability out there to identify what individuals are interested in, what their interests are, who their friends are, they can sweep up a lot of that information through Facebook, through just email, online use of the internet, and use that to turn around and reach out to people who they think are potential supporters. Both campaigns are going to be doing this in a way we've never seen before.
And it really affects how they target their different messages. You might get an email from George Clooney if you are, a person that's interested in Hollywood activities, whereas you might get an email from the First Lady if you're interested in gardening. So they're really able to tell sort of the type of person you are, and then they deploy the right campaign surrogate to be able to see who's going to attract you the most.
That's right. And I think for the media, for us, we want to cover that. It can be challenging because so much of it is individually based. And I think what we're going to see, you and I have also talked about the money that's going to be raised this year. How are they going to spend that money? Are they, a lot of it is clearly going to be television, but television, in a way, is what used to be the way campaigns were run, and it still is important. Plenty of people are watching television, but the internet is the new frontier, and that's what I think is going to be an enormous aspect of this campaign.
Absolutely. Well, we're going to be following every single element of that here at the NewsHour. Thank you very much, Judy, and hope everybody has a great day.